A disease affecting bats called white nose syndrome has been spreading from New York to Oklahoma and is expected to hit Texas bats.
We're very concerned about white nose syndrome impacting bat populations in Texas.
White nose syndrome is named for the fungus that grows on the noses and wings of bats when they're hibernating in winter.
And this fungus is invading the bat's tissues while they hibernate. And basically, the bats are waking up too many times while they hibernate and burning through their fat reserves too quickly, and they're starving to death. And we see between 70 and 100% of the bats die within the first few winters.
They do kind of a vortex, like a whirlwind.
The disease poses no threat to humans.
For those people who want to go out and view bats, there is no concern for contracting white nose. White nose is not something that affects humans at all.
But cave explorers could spread the disease to bats through contaminated gear.
The issue with people entering caves is more about that there could be an ability to transfer the spores on your equipment and your clothing.
To protect Texas bat populations, Texas Parks and Wildlife may restrict access into at-risk public bat caves in coming months.
The only problem that we might potentially see with people is if they're going into caves, which doesn't mean that we're closing all of our caves on public lands, but those caves that we have concerns about.
Oh, look at this.
The public can still visit Longhorn Cavern State Park near Inks Lake, and show caves such as Natural Bridge Caverns are also not affected. When you consider that a single bat can eat up to 1,000 insects an hour, it's worth keeping the little guys healthy.
Bat populations are very important to healthy ecosystems. Bats are primary predators of night flying insects, and many of those are very, very costly agricultural pests.
For Texas Parks and Wildlife, this is Lydia Saldana.